and welcome to my fifth video in the series about cycles, and today we're going to be looking at global warming. So global warming is an increase in the Earth's temperature, and it's caused by the greenhouse effect. The greenhouse effect is a completely natural process, and it keeps the average temperature at relatively 17 degrees Celsius. What it is that it absorbs, or the greenhouse effect causes the absorption of heat radiation or infrared radiation, and that gets trapped by gases around the Earth, so gases like carbon dioxide and methane. And they trap the infrared radiation, hence raising the temperature, a bit like what a greenhouse does. The greenhouse traps in some of the infrared radiation, it causes it to bounce off the window panes, and hence the greenhouse has a slightly hotter ambient temperature than outside. And so this diagram shows us effectively what's happening to heat up the Earth. So the sun produces radiation, and the type of radiation that produces heat is infrared. You can see from the diagram that some of the infrared radiation is bounced back out into space. Some of it gets through to the Earth. Others, other parts of it are absorbed by things like clouds. And then specifically this part here, this shows some of the infrared radiation then being sent back out into space. With no greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide or methane, then all of the infrared radiation would leave and go out into space. Whereas what happens, a bit like a greenhouse, is some of it is reflected back and kept within the Earth's atmosphere, and hence raising the temperature. The more CO2, the more methane that you have, then the more is reflected and kept within the Earth's atmosphere, and hence raising the temperature. So the two major greenhouse gases that cause this effect, one is carbon dioxide, and that produces 50 to 70% of the global warming that we've seen. And the other, which you probably need to know about, is methane. Which is a natural gas, and it's usually produced by things like decomposers when they break down dead organisms. So the key question is, why is more CO2 being produced in the atmosphere? And amongst those reasons, things like burning fossil fuels. I said on a previous video that fossil fuels act like a carbon sink, and when they're burnt they release the CO2. So when fossil fuels are burnt, the carbon is released as carbon dioxide. Deforestation, if you have fewer trees, then there's less photosynthesis, so less CO2 is removed from the atmosphere. And again, if they've been, or if they've undergone deforestation, then you would expect some of those trees, some of that biomass material, to be burnt. And again, when it's burnt, because the trees act like a carbon sink, they release the CO2 into the atmosphere. So this graph shows us some of the carbon emissions produced from different types of fossil fuel. In this case, they've also included cement production. Cement, when it sets, releases CO2 into the atmosphere. And so you can see that the total number of carbon emissions coming from fossil fuels has risen in the last few years. And this corresponds with the actual rise of global temperatures. Now, there's a lot made of the data, and there's a lot of research that's gone in to look at climate change. The majority of climate experts will agree that the increase in global temperatures has been driven by human-based activity. This graph shows us the changing CO2 concentration within the atmosphere. And so you have the year along the bottom, and you have the carbon dioxide concentration along the side, and that's measured in a measurement called parts per million. And now what you'll notice, the overall trend of the line appears to be going up. And this has been the case for at least the last 50 years. What you'll notice with this line, however, is this zigzag effect. So the line has an overall trend of going up, but it has this zigzag effect throughout. And the reason why it has this zigzag effect, and the reason why the CO2 concentration varies from summer to winter, is because of the plants photosynthesizing. You would expect during the summer months the plants to photosynthesize more, and therefore they would reduce the level of CO2 within the atmosphere. During the winter months, you would expect certainly less plant life, and therefore less photosynthesis. Also, if you think about variations within the burning of fuel from summer to winter, you kind of get the idea why you get variations within the CO2 concentration. So in summary, the greenhouse effect is the process by which the Earth has heated up by infrared radiation staying within the Earth's atmosphere. Two major gases responsible for this will be carbon dioxide and methane, as they absorb infrared radiation. A few other things that have caused the increase in the levels of atmospheric CO2 are things like combustion, so that's burning, so burning of fossil fuels, burning of biomass, and also deforestation. If you'd like to join me next time, then I'll be looking at answering exam questions to do with the carbon cycle.